if you have your Bible, come and go with us to the book of going back to the second chapter. We left off with the 11th verse. And if you pick up the request for it, after this, he went down to Capernaum. He, meaning Jesus, his mother, his brothers, and his disciples, and they did not stay there many days. Now, the Passover of the Jews was at hand, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. And he found in the temple those who sold oxen and sheep and goats, and the holy justice doing he drove them all out of the temple with the sheep and the oxen and poured out the changes and was returned to the temple. But he said to those who sold the temple, then his disciples remembered that it was written, "We will for your father." As he conferred for the Jews, for the Jews answered and said, "What sign do you give to us since you preached?" Destroy this temple and in 3 days I will raise it up. He has taken 46 years to build this temple. Will you raise it up in 3 days? But he was speaking of the temple of his father. Therefore, when he had risen from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this to them, and they believed the scripture and the word which Jesus had said. Let us pray to God for this word. So the magnificent temple that Jesus entered with his disciples was the one that he built by the remnant of the ancient Jews who had returned to Israel under Ezra and Nehemiah. He was rendered large and great. So the Jews considered this to be the but the arrival of Jesus and the beginning of his ministry signaled the glory of God, which has filled the holy tribe since the days of the Exodus, and the tabernacle was no longer in the building. That glory was in Jesus, though it was veiled within his humanity. And a day would come, however, when that glory would be revealed. And that would be the day of Jesus' resurrection, the day when the Son of Man would be glorified. The condition of the temple was a fitting indication of the spiritual condition of the nation. Their religion was a dull routine, presided over by worldly minded Not only had the wine run out at the wedding, but the glory of the boat. So when they saw Jesus heal, the disciples remembered Psalm 69:9, "The zeal for thy house hath eaten me up." And Psalm 69 is definitely that is quoted several times in the New Testament. Would be voluntary. man is perfect when he lays down on his life. And then the practice of the Spirit teaches that his faith was taking fruit. His glory to God. His death and burial would look like failure. But in the end, God would be perfect. Aren't you glad that God can come and step around in your faith? But through it all, he was teaching you a lesson so that when you come out of it, you can look back and wonder how I got over it. How you brought me out, how you brought me through. And so many times, that's why you don't get discouraged when stuff doesn't work out the way you think it ought to work out. Pray that God be answered the way you think God ought to be. God sees way ahead of us when we can't even see what's different. And he knows that when you call on him and ask him in prayer to fix something, or you don't know how God's going to fix it, he might have to divert you to another pathway to keep you out of trouble. Oh, my God, has he kept anybody out of trouble? Has he brought anybody through when you didn't know how he was going to bring you through? But when you look back over your life, you can thank him for his goodness and his grace, his mercy and his love. You might have thought he was breaking your heart. Oh, thank God for Jesus. He brought you through, and here you sitting up in here looking better than you ever looked in your life. Got more than you ever had in your life. Strength in your body, peace in your mind, comfort in your soul. Throw up your hands and hallelujah. Oh, bless his holy name. So through these verses here, we see that the temple was the fourth element of the Jewish faith. For giving God what the people did with all the ceremonies and sacrifices that the Jewish religion had taken in the temple. Jesus suggested that the present building would be destroyed. The angry reaction was to get to it. But that was one of the purposes to carry on with the Roman. The legal system was needed, and praise and he is the new sacrifice and the new temple. And then God will tell us later that the new worship will depend on inward integrity, not outward. Now, Jesus was in Jerusalem at the Passover during the feast. Many believed in his name when they saw the sign. But Jesus is not committed to this because he knew and the place of the and had no need that anyone. For he knew what was in him. One who knows it's primary is what you so is the truth that he has to make penetrate to the people of God. Jesus learns that he learns every step of the path. No one ever
Hold on, personal workers. Some of us take a little bit longer than others. Come on, come on. Eternity is too long to mess with your soul. Hell is too hot. Come to Jesus. Come on to Jesus. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Thank you. I'm going to put your hands together and thank you for salvation. You that are sick in your body, you need a miracle. You need God to do something for you. Come on to this altar. Not only will He save you, He'll heal you, He'll strengthen you. Come on and stand today for prayer. If you need prayer, come on and stand. He will heal you. Sing it again, He will heal you. Father, you know the condition of every individual that is in the hotel, from the left to the right. Men and women, young and old, you're ready for your touch. Every thought is in you. You see what the doctor cannot see. You're able to do what medical science. You're able to move out of the walls to the crowd. What the expert is. Because you're a miracle. You are the God of healing. You blew your breath into these houses and commanded us to. You know it from the crown of our feet to the soles of our feet. Every nerve, every tissue,
are things that fix them in the spot. In the mighty name of Jesus. And we give it to you today. Cancer can come. Dementia, Alzheimer's, senility, breast cancer, that only you know about. But we declare you to be a healer today. You are the source of total health, and we yield our bodies to you. We give you these balls to put to touch them. From the crown of their head to the soles of our feet. As we lay our hands upon the people of God, you lay your hands upon them. In the precious name of Jesus, you are Alpha and Omega, beginning and ending. Nothing is too hard for you. And we thank you and we praise you. We give you glory, we give you honor, we thank you. If you're loving today, lift those hands right with us, stand it. And begin praising you. Begin glory. Begin praising you. Begin praising you. Open that mouth, open that mouth. Open that mouth, open that mouth. You are the God that healeth me. You are the Lord, my healer. You sent your word and healed my disease. You are the Lord, my healer. Lift those hands. You are the Lord that healeth me. You are the God, my healer. You take your word and heal my disease. You are the Lord, my healer. He touched me. Thank you.